how to meditate on Sagun Sakar Brahman? Can visualizing techniques and mentally speaking to the deity invoke it?
Yes, yes, yes. See, we allow it. Other traditions are frightened to kind of turn this great principle, the God or whatever, into a personality and to give it form. They say, no, no, you can. We say, we can. As we are human, we might like to think of the ultimate reality in human terms. We might exaggerate the features. Instead of having two arms, they might have four arms. So we do these things, but in a way to engage our attention, saying this is not human, it's superhuman. And through that process, we are in a way engaging with the idea of spirituality by in a way giving it a kind of human, you know, form, format. And so fine, nothing wrong with it. So suppose you are a devout person, and suppose you say, which form? The one that you like, my friend, not the one I like. I mean, I like to focus on Sri Ramakrishna, but I can't impose it on you. You may say, I love Shiva, I love Mother Goddess, good for you. Focus on the form that in a way attracts you because it comes from your cultural, your social, your family background. That's your beginning, starting point, because you've been weaned on it. So focus on that image and build, in a way, try and implore, kind of link up with that image, talk with that image happily. You're allowed to do that in Hinduism. Yes, talk and chat and even scream at him, say, how dare you? You're allowed to do that in Hinduism. You can scream at God even. But that way you are engaging with the idea of spirituality. So allow for it and progress from where you are. You see, we all progress at our own pace from where we are and not where somebody else is. So be it. This is our magnanimous tradition.